Toivotetaan tervetulleeksi vuonna 2004 Finlandia-palkinnonkin saanut kirjailija Helena Sinervo, joka lukee meille Oleg Sentsovin vuonna 2017 kirjoittavan kirjeen. Tervetuloa, Helena.
Everything is good with me. I'm on the move. They took me out of Yakutia abruptly and are driving me to the Jamalonenets Autonomous Okrug. And there is only one place for serving time there, a legendary car. What has occurred there and what is there now, I think you know better than me. Nothing good awaits me on this assignment. Moreover, having already passed through the Irkutsk and Omsk penitentiaries, I have some idea of the pain that awaits me, and not just from stories. Physically, of course, no one is touching me. But you understand very well how the system depravedly punishes and debases you, even without brute force. The Yakutsk headquarters gave me two cards this year, one for New Year's and one for my birthday. But before I departed, they returned to me not just a box with the old letters that they had kept for this past half year, but also 100 new paper postages which they had collected during the year and only now decided to give back. This is what I'm earnestly reading now. They also gave back dozens of books which had been sent but not handed out to me. Cursing everything, I haul this very cherished literature with me through these passages, but leaving it would be a pity. Just don't send me any more books, all right? And do not send me what I don't need and cannot throw away, as I have already handed out what I can and carry the rest with me, and I'm already testing my limits in transporting this portable library. And the packages that aren't ordered for me also don't need to be sent, because packages are given out once every 3 months, and I'd better write to my cousin Natasha or someone else, maybe through you, to explain exactly what I need and get exactly that. Because there were situations when some kind soul would take pity on a poor political prisoner and send some small parcel containing some sort of useless nonsense, and then I would have to wait another 3 months until I would actually receive what I needed. And finishing this pressing topic, ask Sister Natasha to deposit 10,000 rubles, $173, into my prisoner account. It should catch up to me by the time I arrive. Ukrainian Minister of Foreign Affairs, Klimkin, tried to get in contact with me on my birthday in July. And Pussy Riot came to Yakutsk with Alyokina to support me. That was really cool. But instead of giving me a call, they put me yet again in isolation and then actually sent me to an even harsher place, Kharp. The Federal Penitentiary Service of Russia signed this order at the end of July. However, this does not mean that you shouldn't do anything. In general, everything is okay with me, and I hope that I will survive this trip and stay until the end point with my remaining health intact. I hope that on this point you are not becoming hysterical, because I am not alone. There are many of us, and I have far from the worst conditions. I kept track as much as possible of the events in Ukraine and Russia. Ukraine is difficult, but still somehow scratching in the necessary direction. Russia is completely bogged down in this impasse. And of what to do next, no one can be sure. Yet altogether, I have no doubt about our success or victory, or that things will be good, and even great. With this, I must say goodbye, your Oleg Sentsov, Taiyumen, 17th of September, 2017. I will continue by reading two poems of myself, of me, from Space Roses, one in English translation and the other one in Finnish. I heard about her death when a certain woman, when a certain unkempt trollop who looked like a community care case, came to tug at my sleeve in one of the cafes in the town center. My latte was about to slip down the wrong way, and it did. I gasped for a few minutes. They'd been the best of friends, which, from the trollop's point, signified a huge burden of guilt. And I began to suspect that she would have liked to shunt her load onto my shoulders, mine of all people. I was ideal for that sort of thing. My gentle spaniel eyes were like a well into which you could drop anything. I repeat, anything. Because of my sheer sensitivity, I shook myself free and began striding towards the station, which was not a good solution because there, Roma beggars began clutching at my sleeves, one, then the other. Why is it that the Roma are always discriminated against? Wherever they are always discriminated against without much thought. Because of this fact, I didn't have the heart to brush them off. Instead, setting off in a mysterious retinue for the container area of the harbor, where they had erected their filthy camps. Takes for a while to find this Finnish one. Indeed, I want to say that it's in Finland you can be censored too sometimes. I wrote a column about reindeer, about homosexual families of swans, rainbow families. And they didn't publish it. But I kept the theme in my mind. And a couple of years later, I wrote this poem, but I now read it only in Finnish. Rannalla poseeraa taas kyhmyjoutsen pariskunta ja kuusi menneen kesän poikasta. Joutsenten sukupuolta on hankala määrittää ulkonäön perusteella, joten saattaa siinä olla myös lesbopari lapsineen. Linnuilla homous on varsin yleistä, vaikka siitä puhuminen loukkaa konservatiivisia piirejä ja vaikka heteroseksuaalinen perusolettaman istuu varsin sitkeästi, kun katselemme joutsenparin uljaita kauloja. Tietenkin lesbonaaraan täytyy paritella uroksen kanssa hedelmöityäkseen, Mutta se, millaisia parisuhteita linnut muodostavat, onkin sitten toinen juttu. Australiassa yleisten mustajoutsenten keskuudessa homoseksuaaleja uroksia on laskettu olevan jopa 20. Uros houkuttelee naaraan pesälle ja parittelee sen kanssa. Mutta kun munat on munittu, nuo 20 häätää eukon tiehensä. Senkin tutkijat ovat havainneet, että nuo 20 huolehtii jälkikasvusta tasa-arvoisemmin ja paremmin kuin jäljelle jääneet 80. Tämä kaikki on sellaista, mitä konservatiiviset piirit eivät siedä lukea, eivätkä lue. Ajatelkaa nyt Putinia ja Venäjää. Väittävät siellä, että homous on länsivaltioiden rappeutumisilmiö, jota venäläinen terve yhteiskunta ei tunne. Katselevat joutsen lampea, tietämättä millaisia joutsenet oikeasti ovat. Mutta sehän on vain inhimillistä, etteivät he katso totuutta silmiin, sinä sanot. Totuuden katse on kuilun katse. Magneetti, joka imee ja kiskoo jonnekin syvälle. Kiitos. Thank you.